You're listening to the Create What You Speak podcast, where I invite you to come along with me as we shape our own reality together. My intention is to bring out the magic in you. Now let's get started.
Come along now, run away from the humdrum. We'll go to a place that is safe from greed, anger, and boredom. We'll dance and sing till sundown, at peace with abandon. We'll sleep when the morning comes, and we'll rise by the sound of the bird's song.
My name is Sloane Fremont, and today I'm going to talk to you about making the choice that you get to win.
We used to be giants. When did we stop? Just say the word and I'll be yours. You know I never forgot.
The hope and the hurt has lived inside of me.
Hi, welcome back to another week of the Create What You Speak podcast. I am so glad you are here. This week, I want to expand on something we talked about last week, which was making the choice that you get to win. And after I recorded last week's show, that really stuck with me. It was something that I really wanted to talk about more this week. And I also thought it would be a great theme for our new month of July. So I know things are still tough for many of us, and it's really, really easy to get sucked down into that abyss of hopelessness and feel like there's really no relief in sight. And so this mantra of remembering that you can make the choice that you get to win, no matter what the circumstances are, no matter what it looks like right now, it can help you to quickly bring you back to reality and help you to be a little bit kinder to yourself with your thoughts. So we're going to get into that this week, but before I do that, I want to update you on something that I talked about last week. So last week, I mentioned this group, this program, whatever you want to call it, that's called Remote Year, where they do these trips where it used to be all over the world, where you could stay in certain cities for a couple weeks or a month, or I think even longer back then. And they arranged everything for you, your living space, your activities, your co-working space, and anyway, I mentioned last week that they sent out this article or this email that they were starting up these up again all over the U.S. They're not doing them outside of the country yet, but they're starting in Greenville, South Carolina, and New Orleans. And it's the same concept as before. It's for remote workers where they arrange the living, the activities, and the co-working space. And basically, you just show up. And so I went ahead last week. I was kind of on the fence about it, but I went ahead and signed up this week. And I'm doing the New Orleans one, and I thought it would be a great way to just something, right? Like something to break up this monotony. And you know, I talked about this last week. I wanted to share that because I think it sounds really fun. And two, I wanted to see if anyone wants to come along. Like, I don't have any affiliation with this group. I don't know anything other than my, you know, dealings with them, but I just thought it would be cool, and it was something to look forward to. So if you're interested, you can check that out. It's called Remote Year. And one other thing before I get into the show, I want to remind you that my course, 33 Days of Magic, is available in my Etsy shop. And I developed this course so you can take what we talk about in this podcast one step further and apply it in your own life. I've put together a 46-page workbook for you. It's the template for 33 Days of Magic, and that includes the steps to create your magical vision. I teach you the magic method, some magical reflections, and I've got the bonus in case of emergency affirmations for those times when things are just too overwhelming and you need some instant relief. In this program, I really talk you through how to do all of that. It's processes I've used in my own life that have worked, that I've found great benefit from. And so I wanted to share that with you as well. So if you're interested, 33daysofmagic.com. It's the number 33daysofmagic.com. All right, so let's get into this week's topic and our monthly July theme of I get to win. And so let's start out by talking about what do I mean by the statement I get to win? And I talked about this, like I said, on last week's show. And if you missed it, I would encourage you to go back and listen to that episode. It's called Closing Out Old Chapters, because there's a lot of good stuff in there. But this in that episode, I talked about closing out old chapters with ourselves, like closing out the things that no longer serve us. And for me, one of the things I was going through was just, you know, the raging inferno of negative thoughts and those monsters in our head. And so this practice I mentioned last week that helped me start to turn the direction on feeling like shit was allowing myself to win. And so it's let me recap this in case you didn't listen. But here's really what it's about. So I started playing this game with myself where I decide for the day that I get to win. Like sometimes it's not even the day. Sometimes it's like an hour. Like if I'm really feeling, or 5 minutes even, if I'm really feeling really anxious and like crazy in my head, like I decide that I get to win at whatever it is that I want. Like I get to have the thing. Like I get to have the relationship I want. I get to have the, you know, the lifestyle that I want. I get to have the financial whatever that I want, right? Like I get to win. Like, and I get to think the thoughts that are positive and feel good about that, right? And just stop that assuming the worst and the negative, you know, domino effect that our thoughts can cause. And so for the day or the hour or the 5 minutes or whatever it is, I just choose to believe that everything is working out in my favor and that what I want is coming to me and that everything is all right and that I'm right on track and that I get to win. Like today I get to win. I get to win. I get to let myself win. And that, I mean, it is, you know, it's getting that belief started can feel ridiculous. It can feel impossible. It can feel like bullshit. But if you can stick with it long enough, you'll start to see that you can start to, you stop the momentum of the bad thoughts and you allow the possibility of the good thoughts. And what it's done for me is it's helped me to have that glimpse of hope that I felt like I really needed. And so allowing yourself to win with your own thoughts, it's like it helps release that burden and those feelings that everything just sucks, right? In the moment, like it gets us out of our own head and it lets us see other possibilities. Because I know, like for me, when I start to feel like shit, I mean, it just keeps going, right? I pull myself down in that quicksand of negativity and those thoughts just engulf me into more negativity. And it's like, I can't find a way out of it, you know? And as you know, from listening to the show, how we think about things determines how we feel. And negative patterns of thinking, they easily lead us to feeling like shit, right? I mean, easily. And I prove that to myself, like, and I'm sure you have too, right? Like, just start thinking about a negative thought and you're going to feel it in your body, right? Your stomach's going to clench up. Your shoulders are going to like be up by your ears. You're going to like want to like get away from that, right? And then, you know, you add in those feelings of like anxiety and hopelessness and this just like the overall depression, right? And those thoughts have an impact on us and it impacts how we look at the world, how we respond to things, like what we even think is possible. And, you know, obviously the choices and decisions we make. And so if we let those thoughts just go without consciously trying to change them, they can lead us down this path of stress and discomfort and feeling like there's no relief. And that's something I've been struggling with. I talked about that last week. And, you know, I talk about this every week on the show on different ways to address this, because it's not just this one and done kind of thing, right? Everything is constantly changing. We're changing. Our mood's changing. The environment's changing. The world's changing. And so being able to, you know, recognize when you feel like shit and start to have practices that you can quickly fall back to can really help change the momentum into a better place for you, us, all of us, right? Everyone, me included. So how do we release these negative thoughts, right? Like that's the real question. Like that's the one we always want to know, right? What can I do? Like, what can I do? And how do we find relief from our own selves, right? We can't escape from ourselves if we're living human beings. We can't escape from ourselves. So how can we come like in cohesion with ourselves? And how can we stop this bombardment of those shitty thoughts that want to go wild in our head? And, you know, I don't claim to have all the answers, right? But I've done some things that have worked for me, and that's the stuff that I talk about on this show. And my goal and my intent and my hope is that it helps you too. And this week, what is working for me is I found to just let myself win in my mind, like start to believe that I can win, believing that I can have what I want and continuing to let myself believe that I can have the good, that I can believe that the good is coming and trust and have faith in the universe that where I'm at right now isn't the end state. Like this isn't it. Like this isn't how it's going to be forever and that things are always changing and this period wasn't going to be last forever, right? This isn't the end game for me, no matter how much it feels like that's the case. And the same for you, right? This isn't your end game. This isn't where you stop and just okay, this is it, right? No, that's not, like, we have choices. We can look at things differently. We can expect differently. And so deciding to let myself win was for me, this week has been a way to release a lot of that hopelessness that I had been feeling. And I decided to believe that I can get what I want. And I decided to be all in with that belief, right? And believe that I can win and believe that I can have what I want. And I decided to stop dipping in and out of the feeling good and just make feeling good the priority, right? Make it the main focus. Like, stop allowing myself to go back and forth between feeling like shit and feeling good. Like, just making feeling good as the priority. And I also decided to stop thinking that I have to live small and I can only have the scraps of the good and that living big was something I couldn't do, whatever that was, right? Whatever that was. I just decided to change my opinion on that. And I decided that I could build this positive momentum again and just start to feel good, that good things were going to start showing up for me, and to believe that the universe had my back. As cliche as that sounds, I decided to stand firm in that belief. And here's an example of something I just had happen yesterday. So I had bought this online workout program thing and it was like $97 and it wasn't what I thought it was going to be. Like I thought we were going to get more exercises, but it was like an 8-week program. And it was like repeating the same exercises every week, right? You got a different exercise every day, but repeated it over 8 weeks. And I just didn't like that. It was like boring to me. And it wasn't what I thought the program was going to be. And there was all this like complicated macro measurements and stuff that just have zero interest for me. So I ordered this like 2 weeks ago. And yesterday I was thinking about it. And I was like, I wonder if it's too late to just ask for a refund for this. Like, I'm just not satisfied with this at all. And so as I was thinking about it and I sent the email and I said that, I said, you know, this, I understand your program works for a lot of people and that's amazing. It just personally doesn't work for me. It's not what I thought it was going to be. And then afterwards, after I sent that email, I was like, oh my God, they're probably not going to give me the refund. What, you know, they're probably going to be like, oh, you only had 48 hours to get, you know, blah, 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 all this shit, right? In my mind, I was going through all this and I was like, no, you know what? I'm going to decide that I get to win on this. Like, it gets to be easy. It gets to be fine. It gets to be not a big deal. It's like a non-issue, right? And so, and I left it at that. Like, and then I just moved on. And today, less than 24 hours later, they sent me the refund. It was really that simple. Like, it was really that simple. I just decided that I got to win and I let it go and there it was. And so I think, you know, it's easy oftentimes on those things that don't really matter. Was it the end of the world if I didn't get the refund? No, I could have just disputed on my credit card and moved on with my life. But I wanted, like, part of the thing was I just wanted it to be easy. I wanted to be able to make the request and ask for something and just believe that I could have it and let it be easy. And it was like, there was another example for myself that I saw that I proved to myself that, yeah, I can do this. Like, I can do this. I can just let go and trust and it can work for me. And so I think letting myself win and letting myself have these things, you know, letting this refund thing come easy like that. Like, it's, for me, it's helped me to feel better. I mean, accepting that I can feel better, that I don't have to like writhe in this pain and suffering all the time, and believing that there's more consistent joy for me on the horizon, and trusting that I can win, right? I can win at this. And this game that I've been playing, like, I'm calling it a game, you know, of letting myself win, like, for whatever, however, and I say about the time period, because sometimes, like, my mind wants to argue with me and be like, no, you can't win. Like, no, we can't have that. Like yesterday with the refund, instantly my mind was like, they're probably going to be like assholes to you about it. They're probably not going to, you know, blah, blah, blah. And that's not what happened at all. Right. And so sometimes in order to like stop the chatter or the, I don't know what you call it. It's like my mind won't rest unless I believe the shitty feelings. And so sometimes I have to do it for myself just for a certain period of time. And then I tell myself, okay, then after that, you can go back to feeling like shit. And that never happens because once I start feeling good, I stay in that. But it's like giving myself the option to go back and feel like shit and go back to the old way of thinking. For some reason, for me, it calms my mind enough to allow myself to relax enough and believe in something better. That's just something that works for me. And so, and in doing this, it's like it helps me to, it's one of those things that helps me love myself more, like to be nicer to myself in my mind, to like actually partner with my soul, myself, my whatever you want to call it inside you, and trust that this same soul knows the way to what I want, right? Like it knows what I want, and I can believe in that guidance because it's leading me to it. And it's like I'm not this like lost person just flailing around in the universe on my own and so alone, right? I have within me guidance that's pointing me and delivering me to exactly what I want. And I can trust that. I can trust that wisdom of nature and know that I'm being called to what I want. I'm not the same person I was before, so the past won't be repeated. I mentioned that quote last week, and I think that's something else that's important to remember as we decide that we get to win. Like, we're so used to expecting defeated repeats of the past as what we're going to get in the future, but that simply isn't true, right? Like, our future is whatever we want to make of it. It can be whatever we want it to be. We have a blank canvas laid out before us, and all that's required of us is to trust that that good is coming. And I think by deciding that we get to win, it opens up that door and allows us to step through and receive that, right? Like receive the winning, whatever that is for you. And so as you move forward this week, can you start to embody that belief, that energetic space of believing that you get to win? And what does that look like for you, right? Like what does winning mean to you? To me, it means that I get to have what I want. It's that I'm not waiting for some arbitrator in the sky to allow me to have something, right? Like, oh, that they've decided, like, now's your time that you get to have X, Y, or, you know, no. Like, I get to win. Like, I get to make the decision that I want something, and I get to believe and decide that I get to have it. Like, I get to line up with that. I get to win. And so this week, I think, you know, taking some time to think about what that might look like in your life and play that game with yourself. Allow yourself to win for an hour, 2 hours, a day, a week, a month, whatever it is, and start to allow yourself, decide that you're going to allow yourself to believe in those positive thoughts and that you can have what you want, right? That you can have what you want and things can start to change, right? Like things can change. And at least for me, it's helped me to feel lighter and just overall better. It's helped me to let go of that control that we all want to have, which is only an illusion anyway, right? None of us ever have control, but we don't have to know like the why or the how, which we all get wrapped up into, but we just have to allow the universe to surprise us with that. And our job is just to believe that we can have it, right? Like our job is to believe that we can have it. Otherwise, the universe won't know to bring it to us. Okay, that's it this week for our topic and our July monthly theme of I get to win. Deciding that we get to win means that we get to have the conversations with ourselves that allow us to believe that we can have what we want. It's deciding that you can think differently about something, deciding that you can look at a situation differently, and most importantly, deciding that you want to feel good and constantly pivoting your thoughts to those thoughts that feel better, right? Those thoughts that feel better. And walking around with these shitty thoughts and that, you know, dominate for most of us, it's just no way to live, right? Like, it's just no way to live. And in fact, I think it's probably one of the most terrible ways to live, right? There's a quote by Abraham that's, you're so free, you can choose bondage, right? You're so free that you can choose to feel bound in your own mind. And this week, I think, you know, let's not do that to ourselves anymore, right? Like, let's decide that we get to win. And that's your magical intention this week is to decide you get to win. Like care about how you feel and care enough about how you feel that you're willing to do this, right? You're willing to spend this effort on yourself and this time and care about how you feel. Decide that you get to win. And the way you do that is by changing the thoughts that you think and just flat out deciding that you get to win, right? Just deciding that. All right, so that's it this week on our topic of deciding that you get to win. I'm going to talk about the songs that I chose for this show and close this out. So the intro song is called Giants by Dermot Kennedy. He's one of my favorite singers. I think his lyrics are so well written. In this song, we used to be giants. When did we stop? And that's the intro of the song. We used to be giants. When did we stop? And I think that about like ourselves, like this topic of I get to win, like, you know, think about when you were a kid and you thought you could do anything, right? Like you thought you could do anything. And we used to be giants. When did we stop? Like, when did we stop believing in ourselves or thinking that we couldn't have it or thinking that someone else had to give us the permission to have what we want or someone else had to do this or that or the other, right? We create our reality. We're that powerful. We are that powerful that we create our own reality. So we don't have to stop. We don't have to stop believing. We don't have to, and we can decide in any given moment how we want it to go. And we can decide that we get to win. So that's the intro song, Giants, by Dermot Kennedy. The outro song is Otra Noche in Miami by Bad Bunny, Another Night in Miami. I love this song. I love most of his songs. This song is mainly about like being with someone else, like trying to find like, you know, comfort in the arms of someone else or multiple people or comfort in like buying things like the money or the whatever. But in the end, you really just want the one person, like the, whoever that person is for you. And in the song's about just another night in Miami, like trying to do these things to get you off my mind. But in the end, it doesn't work. And I like the song. So Otra Noche in Miami, Bad Bunny. Okay. That's it this week for our topic of choosing that you get to win. I'd love to know what you think of the episode. If you have questions, you can email me SloanFremont@gmail.com. My website is SloanFremont.com. I'm on social media also as Sloan Fremont. And if you like the podcast, please remember to subscribe, rate, and review so more people can find it. All right, that's it for this week. Thanks for listening. And remember, you get to win. Otra noche en Miami. Yeah. Otra noche en Miami.